Okay, you can see, right, that's fine. All right, so my name is Jay Kaur. Okay, I've been a quizzer for life. So I'm a full-time chess trainer. I take chess classes for kids. I used to be a banker. My passion is my profession. So I do quiz content, I do chess, and these are the things I do, right? I've just made a bunch of 40 questions from everything, right, from whatever came to mind, right? So a lot of connect questions, a lot of stuff, right? So we will start right now, okay? So I hope all are ready, right? It's all potpourri, yes. Neither pot nor puri together. So the first question. What is the orange stripe on the milestones which you see across the highways and whatever, the roadways, what does it signify? Can somebody, can everybody see that, right? Hope everything's fine.
Yes.
Yeah, again. Yes, Rajaram, welcome. Yeah. So what is the orange color stripe on the milestones indicate? Anybody taking a guess?
Yes, no. We are all thinking.
Does it mean category of highway?
Category of?
Highway, which, what kind of road it is.
What kind of road it is?
Yeah, like state highway versus national highway versus rural
what
road.
What is orange color? What does orange color signify?
Oh, good question.
Yeah, that is what I want, right? I know it, there are different colors for different, but what is orange indicate?
Rural road.
Okay, I will give it to you, all right?
It's oh, actually, cool.
Actually, the village highway or the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, all right? Any road which is a village road or which is built on the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana will have an orange. The national highway will have yellow, the state highway will have green, and yeah, so that's the so question number two. What connects these? The Horinam Circle in Mumbai, the Raj Bhavan of Kolkata, the GPO camp, Sadhu Vaswani Road in Pune, the Nizamuddin Bridge in Delhi, the AIR building opposite to the assembly in Hyderabad. There is a common connect for all of these. If you find it too hard, I can give you a link, hint. Want to guess?
Yeah. All are built by Nizamuddin.
No way. Nizamuddin in Kolkata. You want a hint?
Yeah.
Okay, I would add Muthuswami Bridge to it.
0 points. Well, 0 points.
This is the point.
0 points, sir.
This is the 0 kilometer point of every city, right? You will see the 0 kilometer stone in every city. The Horinam cycle is also called as a flora fountain, all right? The flora fountain is in the circle, Mumbai, all right? So people know flora fountain as a 0 point. The Delhi, previously it was like the Muthuswami Bridge, which was inside the Fort St. George, which has come out here. The Delhi one was inside Rajghat, at the entrance gate of Rajghat. When they extended it, the stone went inside. Then now they moved it to the highway on the bridge, right? Pune was recently renovated. So that's the point. All these are 0 kilometer points of those cities, right? The national 0 point is in Nagpur. I don't know why, but yeah. The Britishers have it there. So this is the third question. Which element of the periodic table was named after a country that did not exist at that time by that name? Right?
Poland. Poland. Polonium. Polonium.
Polonium and Poland. Wow. Somebody seems to be in full form.
Me, sir. Balaji.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Okay, so Marie Curie found polonium. She was basically a Polish. What happened was Poland has been there from 700 odd years, but during this period of time, they became under the German Empire. So There was no country called Poland by that name. Poland came back into their second independence in 1795. And so polonium was named after Poland when Poland was not a country by name. Identify this location.
Pokhran?
Pokhran. I don't hear anybody's voice. One strong voice. It's Pokhran. Yeah. This was Pokhran 2, to be precise.
Okay.
Identify this character from Mahabharata. My favorite character.
Duryodhana?
No. Anybody else? Any other guesses? Keep guessing. Keep guessing. I want names.
Barbarika.
Yes. Barbarika was the Gadodgaja's son and the grandson of Bhima. For people who don't know Barbarika, Barbarika was the most powerful warrior in the whole of Mahabharata. To be very precise, he was the most powerful warrior. So when Krishna went to each one of them to ask how long the war would last, Barbarika said the war would not last more than 3 days. Because he had a boon from Lord Shiva that he would have an arrow. He had 3 arrows basically. He could send that to kill a whole tribe and the arrow would come back to him, not that it was lost. And it will not come back until it kills everybody. Right? So Krishna wanted to test. So Krishna did a test where he stood over a leaf and said, I want all leaves in this tree to be captured by the arrow. That happened. And there was one under Krishna's feet where the arrow started poking Krishna's leg. So he said, there must be one under your leg. So basically Krishna went to his mother and told if he is going to be there in the part of war. And he said he will fight only for the team which is losing. So he might fight for the Pandavas one day, he will fight for the Gauravas the next day, and third day there will not be anybody left. And hence he wanted the head to be bearded. And Barbarika said, I'm ready to die, provided my head is put over the hill from where I can see the whole war. Okay, so the Kurukshetra was seen by Barbarika from the hill. And that is the symbolism of the head over a hill here. Okay. So this is a temple in Rajasthan called Katusha. And that's Barbarika's story. Yeah.
Great info, sir.
Okay. So this is question 6. Which comic character first appeared in the Daily King Features comic strip? Thimbal Theatre on January 17, 1929. And in 1933, Max Fleischer adopted the same character in a theatrical cartoon shorts for Paramount Pictures. These cartoon shorts are now owned by Turner Entertainment and it's distributed by its sister company, Warner Brothers. So which comic character are we talking about?
That frog thing? No. No, what is it? The no. Green frog thing?
No, not the green frog. Anybody else?
Tom and Jerry?
No way.
Popeye?
That's right. Popeye is Sailor Man. The spinach man. Yeah, that's Popeye. Right, so good answering. Put Funda, I want a story behind this. I like stories. Quizzes are stories. So you have to identify both. One, I put a name. The other is more visible. And what is the story behind it? There is a connect between the two of them. This is the only Carnatic music question I have. I hope people identify both of them, right? Hopefully.
Is it Higgins Bhagavatar, that guy?
Yeah, it is Higgins Bhagavatar. And the one on the left is Kanakadasa, which is already there. So what connects both of them? There's a unique connect between both of them.
Hint, please.
You know Kanakadasa's story, you should make your own story. I hope everybody knows Kanakadasa's story, right? No? we have not been to any temple in South Canada.
Okay, the Udupi temple. Both are not allowed in the Udupi temple.
Brilliant. Both were denied entry into the Udupi temple. The Lord turned around for Kanakadasa for him to have a glimpse. So in that temple, you will see the Krishna not facing east but facing west, right? John Bhagavatar also, John Wickens Bhagavatar was B. Ramanathan's disciple. So he was in love with a lot of Kanakadasa song. He was a great exponent of it. So he was not allowed entry because he was a foreigner. So he also started to sing from outside the temple and songs composed by Kanakadasa. A large crowd gathered to listen to his rendition. The temple authorities did not want to take another chance to allow him inside to have darshan. Right? So that's a connect. A nice connect. Yeah. So, this is the first cricket quiz. There can't be a quiz in India without cricket. So, what number connects these bats? There is a unique number connecting all the four of them. So you can start guessing numbers.
400?
No.
No, Mark Taylor doesn't have a 400.
There's no Mark Taylor there. There is no Mark Taylor there. That's John Wright. Why is everybody looking at the answer and not telling it?
Eight.
So what's the connect? Why eight connects all of them?
I can't guess at all. Right?
Yeah.
Eight short of something. Eight.
All right. So John Wright, Andrew Simmons, Blyam Lara, and Patsy Hedren. These are the only batsmen to have scored maximum eight runs of a single ball, highest in Test cricket. Right? Apparently, Lara's record has been last year. I think with the new rules. Lara's name is basically not there anymore. They have basically taken it out. Because, see, all of them had four runs which they ran, and a four overthrow which makes it eight. Except Blind Lara, who ran three, but when Boucher had tried to hit the stump, it hit the helmet, so he got 5 runs more. When this happened, Lara actually reached 201, right? With that ball hitting the helmet, because the 5 penalty runs went to him. With the new rule last year, the penalty runs are not added to the batsman, but added as penalty in the score sheet. So apparently, since 2019, Lara's name has been removed from this officially, kind of. But all other books still mention that. And he got out on 196, that part, right? Yeah. So that's the point, right? So 8 and 8, yeah. I wanted some number to be the answer. So I said, let me put this as 8. So, which country would you be in if you happen to see this logo?
Saudi Arabia.
Why is that?
Women are not to be depicted.
Not women per se, right?
Fictional characters. Fictional characters not permitted.
So, it's basically the half-naked mermaid. So, mermaid can't be there and women with bare chest can't be there. Kind of not fully covered can't be there. All of that. And so, that's Saudi Arabia. Right? So, this one. This is a toughie, right? So this is from the RBI governor's Shaktikant Das speech last year. And when everything was not looking glossy and whatever. So he said, I'm not saying we maintain a
gloss.
Bangloss. Before I could read the question, the answer is out, right? So people who don't read Voltaire, okay, so start doing it. So it's Dr. Bangloss. And I will just read the question fully. Okay, so countenance and smile away every difficulty. The blank is an adjective derived from a fictional character in Voltaire's Candide. For someone who was optimistic regardless of the circumstances. So, that's Pangloss. Okay. Who or what will connect all of these? The three images.
Rajinikanth.
Why is that?
That musical instrument is Balai Laika.
Okay.
And center one is a private way. That is Yavadi Tarivadi.
Super. This is the easiest one. Okay, so the Alangapadam is called as Zizipas. The name is Jujubi. The name of the fruit is called Jujubi. And yeah, all three. There can't be a question in Chennai. I can't run a quiz in Chennai without Rajinikanth as an answer. Right? So this was my take on this quiz. What does Page Industry sell the most? Question 12. What is that product which Page Industry sells the most? Yeah? Guesses? Start guessing. Quiz is all about guessing.
Is it jockey?
Yeah.
Undergarments?
That's right. It is the jockey. Brilliant. Brilliant answering, right? So, a misnomer. Okay. So, who is said to have written the first Ayurvedic treatise on the diagnosis and treatment for ailments occurring during the trimester, childbirth, and a post-childbirth pediatric?
Charaka.
No.
Sushruta.
No.
Agnivesha.
Who?
Agnivesha.
No. This was called Kumara Tantra. He wrote because his wife wanted him to write about it at the birth of his eldest son, whom he liked the most. So according to the Indian Ayurvedic, this is considered as the first to be written. This is what I can give you. We need to go a little back than what the names you put. He also wrote a book called Arkya Prakasa, right? That was the most famous one, which was basically on aromatherapy. And that's why the distilling of the aroma from the flowers again for treatment in Ayurveda, right? And that's why you get arak. The word arak comes basically from the process of distillation. Can I close this? Can I give the answer? Any more guesses? Anybody wants to guess? Can I? Okay, I will reveal the answer.
Oh, Ravana.
Yeah, it is Ravana, the king of Lanka. He has actually written, there are two treatises which is available as a book even now in Sanskrit and English translation. The book on the aromatherapy is called Arkya Prakasam, and this one is called the Kumara Tantra. Kumara Tantra is on childbirth, trimester, and pre and pro natal and the whole thing. Right? So,
I've heard about Kumara Tantra, but not sure. Today I got to know.
Okay, so that's the story. So who was the first German-born tennis player to win the Wimbledon men's singles title?
Boris Becker?
No.
More.
Who else can it be?
Andre Agassi?
Oh, wait. I guess he was born in Las Vegas. And I guess he was after Becker anyway. after the Kirstik and then only again.
Steffi Graf?
Not the men's singles title.
Men's singles.
Yeah, that's why I mentioned men's singles.
Oh, men's singles. Sorry.
Yeah, no problem. Even Steffi Graf is not the answer. Even I would have put German player. Okay, so I would have said Wimbledon singles. It still holds good. Okay, so I'll give you a clue. He never represented Germany. He was German born, but never played under German flag. Any guesses? Tell all the tennis players' name you know. Right? That's what happened, right? That's what quizzing is all about. Right?
What level?
Not so late, not early, right? In the 80s.
Borg?
No, nope. Borg was Swedish.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Boris?
Not Boris. Okay. So I said he did not represent Germany, right?
Okay.
His father was in the military, right? So he was posted in Germany. And hence he was born there. Okay, so. John McEnroe.
Oh.
John McEnroe was born in Germany. So the old question, which is been out of circulation for quite some time in the quizzing circle. So I thought, let me put this. All right. So this is another interesting. What connects this? Can you put some padda behind it? I think you identify all six of them, right? At least four, five of them. So what's the first one? What is this? Flag of which country?
Iraq.
No, not Iraq. One of the two countries which starts with A and doesn't end in A.
Azerbaijan.
Not Azerbaijan, the other one. Afghanistan. Right.
Afghanistan.
So this is the Afghanistan flag. This is a piggyback. This is a pigeon. This is a pup. This is a puka. I will not tell you what this is. But with this five, if you can find something good, you can't, then I will tell you this. But if I tell you what this character name is, I think most of you or some of you will track it. This character, cartoon character, is called Binga. B-I-N-G-A. Nobody watches cricket.
Not even this.
Nobody likes the Australian team. These are the nicknames, right? So Mark War was called Afghanistan because that was called the Forgotten War. He was a war which was always forgotten. People always spoke only about Steve, even though Mark was a better player. Right? So he was called the Forgotten War. Afghanistan War was called the Forgotten War, and the rest are all their nicknames. That's how they were called. So all Australian cricketers' nickname. I've just taken that out. Right? So this is the most easiest question of all. Kotak Mahindra has a
demonetization.
Yeah, that everybody remembers. Everybody stood in queue. So I didn't have to stand in queue to get the answer. That's nice. All right, question 17.
Yeah.
This is Star Wars, right? What nine word phrase completes this? Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of Starship Enterprise. It's a 5-year mission to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilization. --9.
Only go where no man has gone before.
Brilliant. This is what my sales manager always used to say. Make sure you boldly go where no man has gone before. Get the sales from that place. Right? So, my boss was a Star Trek freak, so he always used to say this. Right? You have to boldly go where no one has gone before and bring the sale. So that's a good one. In 1948, the Godrej Group set up a manufacturing line in Mumbai suburb Vikhroli.
Voting box.
That's the one, ballot box. Okay, so in order to need to fulfill in 4 years' time, 1952 was the first election. So the ballot box for the first general election, the order went to Godrej, and this is that box. Good, that's good. Who is this?
Yomina,
the robot, ISRO robot. It's called Yomitra. Okay. She's a half humanoid robot that ISRO plans to send to space this December. Right?
Yes. That's good.
So, this is recent. For which of this book on the British Empire did Shashi Tharoor win the Sahitya Academy?
Era of Darkness.
Era of Darkness. Yes. It is the Era of Darkness. A nice book, actually. Right? I love reading it. Worth it. Okay. What comes next? It is a sequence. So, I want to know what comes as a fifth in this list. So you need to identify something. You need to see what is the connect. Tell me what comes last.
Waste.
Okay.
Cut, copy, paste, something like that.
What comes last?
Open, cut, copy, paste, I don't know.
You are on track.
Copy, paste, right? It's something.
There is no copy there.
Cut.
You are on track, right? So, yeah, got something to do with.
Edit.
No. Ah, software person must say.
Undo.
Undo. How is that?
Because paste. First one is paste. Second one is new. Third one is cut.
How does, why do you say undo? Why does undo come there?
These are menu options. So.
Oh. Can you give me a precise? Undo is okay, but can you tell me why it's undo?
I was thinking more along the menu options.
Like what is the menu option? Can you just explain so that others also can? So what is paste? How do you paste something?
Copy, paste, right?
No. You are there. Okay, you are there. But
in the edit menu. Okay.
These are all shortcut keys. So, Control V is paste. Control W is open window. Control X is cut. Control Y is redo. So, the last one is Control Z, which is undo.
Okay. Yeah. I was thinking along the menu options, but okay. I didn't think of the shortcut
key. Yeah, it's all shortcuts where it's Z, W, X, Y. And the last one is undo, right?
Yeah, I was thinking more, these are the regular, most commonly used menu options.
Okay, so yeah, so that should be Control C there, right? So
right,
that,
yeah.
Copy is not there, right? So it's usually Control V, Control W, Control X, Y, Z. Right? All right. Which point on Earth is closest to the moon?
Antarctica?
Oh. It has to be high, right?
Everest?
No, surely not. This is way too taller than Everest. Now everybody thinks. What peak can be taller than Everest? This actually, I put it in the Neengalum Ellalam Oru Kodi series, right? This was one of the questions where the host Aravind Swami wanted a proof before he could
go and ask. Petronas Towers.
Which one?
Petronas.
No, no, Petronas is all too short. I'm saying this is taller than the Everest, right? So there has to be some
fundamental distance or something.
That's right. Okay, so that's a point, right? So it's Mount Chimborazo, which stands close to the equator. So for people who don't know, the Earth is not a perfect sphere. There is a ridge across the equator, which is close to 42 kilometers high, right? So from the lowest point to the highest point. So Mount Chimborazo stands over it. Even though Mount Chimborazo from the sea level is not even the third tallest peak in South America, it still stands over the ridge, because of which it is much higher. So when you stand over it, you are standing at the tallest point on the planet Earth. It's a nice panda, you can actually go read about it, right? So Mount Chimborazo is the most closest point to outer space, and people who are now looking at moon try to go there to do it, right? Okay, so that's the answer on it. All right, this is Asterix. Sean Connery appeared in the comic book Asterix and the Black Gold, that's the name of the title, for which he was paid £1,000,000. What was the name of the character?
006.
006, bingo. So 006 took his double examination 6 times and failed, hence his name. All right, so 007 got demoted to 006 for £1,000,000. This was after his last movie as the Bond, all right? So he said he would not do it until he was acting as a Bond. So when Roger Moore did the Moonraker, this came out and he was called the 006. Right? So, this, what connects these? Who or what connects these? Anybody try? I know you can identify all 4 of them. Okay, then start guessing.
Is it all Rajnikant's movie?
Vikram, I don't think is a Rajnikant movie.
Yeah, but
there can be only one question on Rajnikant in a quiz.
Sujata.
That's the right
answer. Director Sujata.
That's the right answer. He is the man, right? So my favorite author. So that's one. So Vikram, Shivaji, Ayudha Ezhuthu and Roja are all his stories which have been made into movies. So, and that's the whole point, right? Yeah. Good. That's a nice crack. Where can you see the letters F, G, H and J, K, L in the correct sequence?
Keyboard?
Yeah. You've got to look down on your keyboard. The QWERTY keyboard is a place where you would see F, G, H and J, K, L in a perfect sequence. Yeah. So, yeah, that's a good one. Yeah. I'll give you a nice story on this. This was also in the Oru Kodi. I said this question. And when this was actually to a lady who had been a typist or a stenographer in a government office for 20 years before she got promoted. And when this question was actually asked on air, she actually typed AS, GF, DF, LK, JH, J, like, you know, imaginary, so that, and then she formed the other half, right? So, yeah. That's
it. Yeah, I guess most of the software developers also can crack this.
sometimes what happens is that, you know, we usually word it in such a way that one is JKL, what is the other one, right? So if you have been to typing, then you would do it quickly, or else you'll have to look down to find it. So what connects these two people? This is the politics question. You all know who those two are, right?
License Raj.
What? No.
License Raj.
How can the man on the right be from the License Raj?
Yeah, beneficiary.
If it had been a License Raj, I would have put Ambani's post face, Dhirubhai Ambani's face there in his face. This question was inspired by the first connect question I ever heard, maybe some 25 years back, right? So it was my first quiz, and my first connect question was something on the same line, so kind of always enthralls me on that. Okay, so you know both of them, right?
Rahul
Bajaj and Indira Gandhi. So what connects both of them? Any guesses? I don't hear a lot of voice, a lot of silent spectators. Still fine.
Don't know what to guess.
You don't know what to guess. All right.
Raj.
Okay, Sanjay Gandhi's original name was Sanjeev, unless until he got caught in London and they had to get a fresh passport for him to be out of record and whatever. So Sanjeev Gandhi suddenly became Sanjay Gandhi one fine morning, right? So both of them have sons named Rajiv and Sanjeev. And as for the 25 years back question, the question was what connects Pramod Mahajan, Rahul Dev Barman, Sachin Dev Barman and Gautam Buddha. All of them had a son called Rahul, right? So inspired by that, this question has come up, right? Okay. So what's a good word, right? So this is the word question. Due to complexities in counting Roman numerals, the Roman kings of England used a cloth to divide in squares that covered a table. It was on this cloth that all accounts of revenue were reckoned with counters, and apparently reminded people of a chessboard. The word that come to mean treasury in the financial sense of the word. So what's that word?
Exchequer.
Exchequer, absolutely right. So the British finance minister is still called?
Chancellor of the Exchequer.
And Chancellor of Exchequer, right? So yeah, so that's the word, good. So what is depicted here in the 1905 painting by Abhinandan Abhitranath?
Mother India.
This is Bharat Mata. Yes. Good. Yeah. So any India questions? Balaji would be there.
Yeah.
All right. So this is the finance question. So what term borrowed from fox hunting describes a preliminary prospectus issued by stock undertaking firms to gauge investors' interest in a prospective stock offering? So if anybody is interested in putting in IPO, we'll know this. Nobody invests in market. Is that so? Can you be a little loud, please? Okay. So. Yeah, what are the things you hear when an IPO comes in? Any guess? I thought this was easy. Okay. Can I reveal the answer? Anybody wants to take a guess?
Is it Indian first order? IPO?
No. IPO, I see IPO is basically initial public offering, right? So when you apply for a stock for the first time.
Okay.
There are some documents which come out, right? Which people look at before they start to invest, seeing that whether it's worth investing or whatever. So that document which comes out, right, which basically gauges the investor's interest in buying the stock or whether they want to invest in a company. This document is, the word is taken from fox hunting, right? And the word is called red herring. So it's called the red herring document or the green document, which is what comes out before an IPO comes in, right? So yeah, that's on stock market. This is on currency. Name two Nordic countries to have euro as its currency. There are only two Nordic countries which do not have anything to do with the word crown. So, which are the two countries to have euro as its currency? The Nordic countries or the European countries. Guesses?
Denmark and Sweden?
No. Both of them have crown. Kronar, crown.
Finland.
One is Finland, other one is?
Norway.
Iceland.
No.
Norway?
No.
Sweden.
I can give you a hint. It was previously an Eastern Bloc country. One of those which broke away from the USSR.
Lithuania.
Not Lithuania, you're close to it. Then a country next to it.
Estonia.
It's Estonia and Finland. These are the only two countries to have euro as its currency. The rest are all still having kronar or whatever. The crown, basically. Okay, so this is my favorite question for the quiz because the answer is going to be I found the answer, so I made this question, right? So, whose Twitter account has the description, actor, producer, and running in films since 1981?
Tom Cruise.
Bingo. So, now the answer is a minute answer, so I'm going to let you all enjoy. I hope you hear the volume. You hear the audio?
No.
Okay, I thought you would hear the audio. All right, anyway.
No, because you are on headset, we don't.
No, I can't hear anything.
Tom Cruise.
They put it because I said it.
Can you hear it now?
Tom Cruise.
Yeah. Answer is already given. The answer is already given. It is Tom Cruise. Yeah. It's actually a minute video. Okay, so that's
a significant running.
Okay, so what connects these? If it was with the audio, that would be nice, but yeah, it doesn't go on Zoom. There are a lot of images of birds. You want a hint?
Yes, sir.
Does anybody want to guess before I give a hint?
Software company or software?
No, nothing to do with software. This is sports. This, all these four are to do with sports. There's a sport connect to it. Any guess? Anybody guessing?
Golf.
What is the connect? How is it called connected to golf?
An eagle is like two under par kind of a shot.
Okay. Okay.
What are the other ones? I think there is one.
Birdie.
That's...
Birdie.
Yeah. Okay. This is birdie. This is eagle.
There is like a bogey, right?
This is a bogey. Okay. Okay. The first one is called albatross. All right. So all these are golfing terms. So albatross is a hole in one in a four, under three. Birdie is under one. Birdie is under two. Bogey is under. Bogey is okay. Eagle is under one. Birdie is under two.
No, birdie is under one. Under one. Eagle is under two. I think.
Okay. Yeah. And bogey is one over.
Plus one.
Yeah. Plus one. So all these are golfing terms. Yeah. So I couldn't find a bird for par, so I left it on par.
Partridge. You have to cut it off.
So what comes next? Right. So the clue is obvious, but you need to know what comes next.
Pulvations.
There is a sequence to it. So, yeah.
First one is Navaratri 9, right. And then Dasavataram 10.
Yeah.
Avatar.
Nambiar acted as 11 roles in this Digambara Sambhya.
Yeah, Digambara Sambhya, Nambiar acted in 11 roles. So who acted in what film in 12 roles? That's your question. The connect has been found. So what comes next is... And the fourth one is not a Tamil movie. That's the hint I can give. That was the only movie with one actor doing 12 roles. So I had to take it. Any guesses? No? Yes?
We found the connect, but not the movie.
Okay, so the 12 is what is your rush? Okay, so Priyanka Chopra acts in 12 different roles in that. This was a movie 5-6 years back, right? So Roni Screwvala's movie. So that's the character, that's a artist with 12 roles in one single movie. All right. So next one is a mythology question. In the Mahabharata, when Yudhishthira decided to do the Rajasuya Yagna, the Pandavas went around the country inviting kings to Indraprastha. Bhima was sent to the east. Arjuna went north. Sahadeva went south. And Nakula went to Hastinapur. To which kingdom and which king was Gadodgaja sent with an invitation? My mythology questions would be a little tough, but still, since it's mythology, I like to think outside the box. So it has to be, it's not the usual stuff. Think outside the box.
Is it Nagas?
No. Any guesses? Take a wild guess. Think outside the box. Think outside Mahabharata.
The question is that Gadodgaja was which side he was sent? No?
Where, to which place he was sent and to invite who? Who was a king and which kingdom? Or which place and who was a king? Right? So if you know the king, you know the place, you know the place, you know the king. It's kind of one. If you know one, the other is easy, kind of. So I'm asking you to think outside the box, think outside Mahabharata, right? So that's a clue I can give you. We had one on Bargarika, now we are having one on Gadodgaja. Any guesses? Anybody want to guess? Yes, sir.
Devaloka, Indra?
No. Okay, we had Ravana, so we'll have Vibhishana.
Oh.
Vibhishana is one of the Chiranjeevis, eternal youth in Hindu tradition. So technically, he was still alive, at least as far as Mahabharata goes. So Sagadeva goes south, and then he can't cross the ocean, so he calls up mentally Gadot Gaja to take the invite to Vibhishana, since he was the only one who could try across the ocean, just like Hanuman did. Right? So that's the story behind Gadot Gaja and Vibhishana. Right? So that's the story there. All right. This is India's favorite question. The Indian first name X comes from the Sanskrit name Y. Y is a name given to Hindu mythological god Indra, which means Izzet's Indra, right? Okay, so there is a word before Indra, which is also a name for Indra. And Izzet also happens to be the wife of Indra. Just to add more this thing, X also means essence. So what is X? Who is X? The famous X. I think Gopu with the Sanskrit would find what X means. Right?
Vasu.
So you have to know different names of Indra and name of one of the many wives of Indra. But everybody knows X. If I give a simple clue, everybody will know the answer. If I just add one word to X, everybody will tell the answer. X is the Indian god of the 20th century. Who is the Indian god of the 20th century? Or the 21st century?
Sachin. Oh.
Sachin means essence. So Sachin comes from Sachindra, one of Indra's name, and Sachi is Indra's wife. Okay, so that's where the Sachin comes in. Right? So I have had Rajinikanth, I have Sachin. So I made sure that the quiz is complete. Right? So there can't be a quiz without these two. Okay, so now from Mahabharata we go to Ramayana. In the Ramayana, when Rama went to Vanavas, his brother Bharata ran and can't take a government from which place?
This question is
Nandigram. Yeah, this was inspired by Balaji's last week of self-immolation. Let's not do a self-immolation, but find the place. So yeah, the caretaker was from Nandigram. Good, that's an easy crack. What does a male penguin present the female penguin as part of their courtship ritual? Actually, I have a 3-minute video, but I didn't want to put a 3-minute video. This is very unique. Penguin is the only animal which basically lives with one partner all through the life. They don't switch partners. They are partners for life. Correct? So,
there are several birds that do that. So.
All right. So what does the male present the female as a part of courtship issue?
It takes care of during the gestation period.
No. It gives something. There is a present which is given. That is how the whole partnership starts. Right? Just like the engagement ring or whatever. No? The proposal happens only with gifting of this. Only if the female accepts it, then it means that the courtship can start. What does a male penguin actually give the female penguin?
A fish?
Nope. Any more guesses? I'll wait for one guess before I reveal the answer. Okay, so it's actually a pebble to build a nest. The male penguin actually gives a female penguin a pebble once the female accepts, it means that they have become partners, and with that they start building the whole nest from where the whole family starts to happen. That's unique about penguins. Okay. What connects these Sherlock Holmes stories? The adventure of the Bruce Parrington plants, the Greek interpreter, the final problem, and the empty house.
These are Mycroft Holmes.
Huh?
Mycroft.
Mycroft Holmes, the brother of Sherlock Holmes, appears in only these four stories. Right. So that's a good one. Right. We are into the penultimate question of the day. In 1951, which country became the first country to be declared independent by the United Nations?
Morocco.
No. You are close geographically.
Tunisia.
Huh?
Tunisia.
No.
Algeria.
No. You are going around the country.
Liberia.
Liberia is...
No, sorry.
I know you wanted to say something, but said something.
Yes. Lebanon.
Lebanon is in Middle East.
No. Nothing.
Yeah, I know. You got the first letter, but not getting the other letters.
Libya.
After years of local resistance to the Italian occupation, and following the Italy's defeat in World War II, the United Nations General Assembly adopted a resolution on 21st November 1949, granting Libya its independence no later than 1st Jan 1952. So, end of 1951, Libya became an independent country. The last question. What is I 2 bar 2, C 1 bar 1, P 2 bar 2, and M 3 bar 3?
It is the dental formula.
That's the answer. Bingo. That's perfect. A dental formula for humans, which is on the upper, the one side of your upper basically is two incisors, one canine, two premolars, three molars, which is on one side of your upper two.
Okay. Yes.
So, yeah, that brings us to the end of the quiz. I know that it was a little tough, but I hope everybody enjoyed.
It was very interesting. Yeah. Great job, yeah. Perfect.
Very engaging. Thank you, Jaikar. Very engaging.
Thank you, Mr. Jaikar.
Thank you, quizzes also.
Yeah, okay.
Not a common one that we hear regularly.
Yeah, so see, I wanted to basically make it more infotainment. So you get a lot of stories from where you can actually build. Like, I would know that Balaji would come out with 50 questions in the next 50 days from these 40 which I've done, right? So it opens out a lot of...
We all got good information today.
Yeah, that's precisely the whole idea, no? 1 hour, 40 questions.
And lots of learning. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank Keshav, thank. Yeah.
Thank you,
sir. Very nice.
Vintage
Jaika. Thanks, Keshav.
We look forward to more sessions like this.
Yeah, we can. If you want...
Yes, for sure.
We can actually take a topic like last time when Balaji did India, kind of. So we can actually take up a topic and...
Often. For all those who do not know Jaikar, he can conduct every day. Because there was a time some 10 years back, we used to have a quiz between 9 and 10 in Facebook. They're all our friends from, Gulf, US, Europe. All of us used to join. What I'm saying is all 10 years back. So
he would get bored. We have to prepare for his quizzes.
I'm just saying that is what he's capable of. So
okay, so yeah, I have a huge database, right? So I keep for us basically quizzes.
Jaikar, niye or database.
All right, so the whole funda happens this way that I have a question, I have an answer, but the question keeps changing, but the answer remains the same, right? So a barbarica can come in 5 different ways, right? So I can just give you a couple of one barbarica, right? Because he happens to be my favorite. He was one of the 5 characters who heard the Gita live when it was done by Krishna to Arjuna, right? Krishna and Arjuna were one. The other three were basically, do you know who the other three were? Other than Parvarika, who were the other two?
Sanjaya and Dhritarashtra.
No, not Dhritarashtra. Sanjaya.
Uddhava. Uddhava.
Hanuman.
Hanuman on the flag, right? So, yeah. The Hanuman on the flag, and then Sanjaya, who was a live webcast or broadcast or whatever. And then you had Krishna, Arjuna, and Barbarika. So the Barbarika can be, can be in different forms. So that's how I work. I have an answer, and then I make a question around it, right? So the whole database would be question answer, but every time it can't be the same question. So it is answer the same, but the question keeps changing, right? So yeah. So you always never run out of questions. Per se, right? So that's how it works. I think I've given a lot of ideas to people to start working on those modules, right? If you just start going back, you will find take 10 topics. Or I basically did this. I had 16 topics which I wanted to do. And then I put 1-2 questions, some I had 3 and something like that. And then made sure that all topics are covered and make it interesting. So that,
great session. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you very much.
Really fun Sunday.
Yeah. So who's doing next week?
I look upon you guys. I only know both of you, Balaji and the Jaikar. So.
Gopu, can you pitch in?
No, not this week. I got too many things. But,
okay. All right. Okay. So you can be a treasure trove on temple.
So. Too much work. You guys put in so much work. That's amazing.
So sometimes, you do it on a regular basis, then you spend a little time building a question base kind of. So, yeah, I understand.
I could try helping you, Jaikar, with a few questions.
All right.
And maybe I could shoot across a few and then see if we can help.
Maybe somebody can do half and half, right? If you can do 15, 20 questions, then I think we can.
I'll try my best.
Yeah, so. Hey, for so all of you, Keshav is a good friend of mine, right? He's a trainer, management trainer, but also used to be a host doing quizzes long back in AsiaNet, and he was a host.
Amrita and Raj TV.
Yeah, Amrita and Raj TV.
Doordarshan, of course.
And Doordarshan, of course, yeah. So he used to
good old days when nobody used to watch them. We were all safe.
Right, so yeah, so he used to do a weekly quiz on all these channels over different periods of time. A good friend of mine. So thanks, Keshav. So
I could pull out something from my database and we'll run it through you and see how it goes.
Yeah, so that should be fine. Yeah, we can. Chalo.
Thanks, Keshav, for coming forward.
Thanks
for the info, Jaikar.
Yeah,
it would be fun actually if we probably do every Sunday a quiz day kind of thing.
Yeah, we actually can do, but provided, the point is there can be a few more volunteers. See, the point is even if somebody does 10 questions, right, that should be ideally fine. 3 of us can ideally do 10 questions, 20 minutes each, I think.
Yeah, I think collaborate.